Hi. Today in this module, I'm going to explain you how to model from 2D to 3D, starting from simple 2D layouts. And I will be using some Qixcat specific tools like QuickDraw, but I also will explain you how to use some standard direct modeling tools like Extrude and Pushpull. So let's start with the first example.
Okay, so first example, I will be using a tool of QuickDraw to trace over existing simple 2D floor plan and create a 3D model from it. So here I have my drawing open, where I can see I have just a couple of lines ready to use. So these are just polylines and lines. And let's start with this layout and go to the Home tab and use the command QuickDraw right here. And then you will see this special cursor appears indicating the locations of the walls that you will be creating. So if I hover over it and you see that I'm near the lines, it will snap into those lines. And then I can click on it once and hover over the other side of the room. You see it will snap to the existing lines. If I click now, you see automatically I will be creating four walls and a floor slab. Like that, I can continue by snapping to a corner right here, for example, and go out to create an L-shaped room. You see there is a part that's red, indicating that that part of the wall will be deleted. So if I click now, you see that I have created an L-shaped in this building. Okay, again, let me just zoom in here a little bit and create the inner walls. You will see that the walls or the cursor will adapt to the thicknesses of these lines. So here you see that these lines for the inner walls are a bit thinner than the outer walls, so you see a clear distinction in that as well when you're doing this in the QuickDraw command. Here again, let me just snap to a corner, and like this, I finish my layout like this. Here, of course, these are some default values for slab thicknesses and room heights and so on, but you can change this, of course, in the settings. So if I type in S and press Enter, you will find all the QuickDraw settings that I can set for default floor-to-floor distance, default wall width, default slab thicknesses, and so on, and automatically adapt the sizes as well. So here you have some choices to do that. Following along, here I can click on the plus sign to copy the entire floor or just outer walls or create a flat roof. So let me just add in some more floors. So I just click the button four times, so I have in total five floors, and then I can create the rooftop or flat roof. Like this, I can press Enter or press Escape to finish the QuickDraw command. The QuickDraw command automatically gives all the elements a correct classification. So if I hover over this, for example, you will see this is classified as a wall. Here it's classified as a roof. So this is automatically done. So that means that after using only QuickDraw to transform a 2D plan into a 3D building, we don't need to classify these elements anymore. It's automatically done for you. Of course, it's still a good habit to regularly check. You can do that by using the structure browser here, for example, and you will see that I have a building, and then for each building, I have a floor, and for each floor, I have the distinction between wall and slabs. So, like that, you can check if your classifications are all right or not. So that's it. So let me go over. So this was with QuickDraw, but we can also create this 3D model by using direct modeling tools. So let me go over to this other drawing. Okay, so the previous section consisted of rectangular layouts aligned with the current UCS. The second example right here is not so simple. You see that the outer walls are not aligned with the UCS, and I also have inner walls that are not perpendicular, and I have a cylindrical wall right here. So in this case, quick draw wouldn't work. As well as the previous example. So in this case, we're going to use a different method, which is direct modeling instead. So let's zoom in a little bit and orbit around to see the lines a little bit better. So you can see like this, these are just regular lines. And I'm just going to enable boundary detection so that we'll detect all the surfaces enclosed within lines, for example. So if I zoom in here a little bit and hover in between the two lines, you will see that I have a green surface, and that is my boundary between the two lines. Let's go to the quad cursor, and you will see that I have an option to extrude this, and I can extrude this upwards for about 3,000 millimeters and press enter. So I've created my outer walls of this building right here. Let me also go ahead and orbit to see the bottom. Select the face of the bottom right here, and instead of extrude, use push-pull to pull the wall down a little bit. By 250 millimeters, press enter like this. So I have a bottom part as well. So you can see here now I've created a boundary between the lower edge of the walls and the layout line. So if I zoom in here a little bit, you will see that I can also detect the boundary between this line and the edge of my existing wall. If I select this boundary and I also extrude, I can create a slab. So for example, I can create a slab until here, maybe like so. And then here I have a little bit of a difficult part because I have a cylindrical wall here. So I can just zoom in. Let me turn off the boundary right now and zoom in and select the surface here and use connect to nearest. So find it here. In the command line, you can use T connect for that. And what it does is it will connect your surface to the nearest solid. So like this, I can perfectly create this connection right here where I have a slab that follows along the cylindrical slab right here. Okay, and then lastly, I want to split the wall. So if I select the walls right here, you see this is one solid, but it's a BIM best practice actually to construct every wall and or every other entity in a BIM model separately, so that for every entity you can have like their own separate BIM data, such as classification, number, composition, fire rating, and so on. So let's split these walls into separate entities instead of one big one. So you can do this manually, but you can also do this automatically with if you select the solid and then go here to BIM split here. So split segments, solid segmented solids into separate entities. So if I click on that, you will see now instead of one big solid, I have a couple of other ones. So actually, I have three because here with the cylindrical wall right here, it just take this as one big entity, so we can adjust this manually as well. So I'm going to do that with slice. And here I have to choose, no, sorry, multi-slice. So that's this one right here, and then I have to select a surface where I want to have the wall perpendicular to this part. So if I select this, I can slice until here. So like this, I now have sliced this wall and this wall into separate entities. So let's do that for the other side as well. And just slice this part right here. So now I have like one part, which is the cylindrical wall, and then one straight, two straight, three and four. So in total, I have five walls instead of one big solid. Okay, let's do the inner walls as well. So let me turn on the boundaries again and zoom in a little bit. And if I hover over the lines, you will see boundary. And again, I just select extrude to create the inner wall. So in this case, as well as 3000 millimeters for a height, so we can create this part right here. Again, this is one solid. Preferably, we want to have two separate wall solids, so you can use BIM split to create this. And of course, these kind of connections you can adjust later on as well. So for example, here, this connection right here, you can select both of the walls and choose L connect to see if you want this connection, for example, mitered or the other way around or separate. So that's up to you on how you want to have your wall connections. So if I just press enter now, I can have this separately. Okay, so now I think this is mostly done. So I can just select everything and copy my floor to the next level. So copy, or I can use the quad, of course, and then just choose the second base point. I can also type in R for repeat to repeat the same distance and copy the same floor. So like this, I can do this fairly quickly. So let's say until somewhere here maybe. You see that all my floors are copied up. Let me just copy the last floor only with the outer walls, without the inner walls. So I can do this like so, choose a base point and an end point like this. Lastly, for the roof, so this would be my roof. Let me just lower these outer walls a little bit. So if I select one of the solid faces and I go to select aligned faces, then I can, so you can select the top part surface and have everything aligned. So select aligned surfaces. So now you see all the top surfaces of my outer walls are selected. And in this case, I can use push pull to drag it up or down, in this case down by 2500, to have like a rooftop edge. So like this, I have my basic envelope of my building. Lastly, before with QuickDraw, everything was automatically classified with wall classifications, roof, slabs and so on. But here, because we use direct modeling tools, it's not that intelligent. So if you check, for example, this wall right here is just a 3D solid. It doesn't have any specific wall properties, for example. So you see nothing is classified in this case. So we can add some more intelligence to it. For that, I'm going to use BIMify. And as you can see here, so I can turn off maybe in this case spaces and sections, so you can just see that it's what automatically classify all my solids and my blocks in my drawing. If I have some profiles, it will also detect the profiles and create some spatial locations as well. But let's see for general, like the classification, how it works. If I just apply it, you will see that now if I hover over an entity, now it's classified as wall, classified as slab, and so on. So like this, I can have some more information in my building. So you can see here also nicely sorted within each and every floor. And then for a floor, you have a slab and 8 walls, for example. So now this is nicely cleaned up and classified for me.
So that was it. So I showed you how to model from a 2D layout and model a 3D model. One time with QuickDraw and then one time with direct modeling tools. Of course, you can also combine the two methods and do a hybrid example. But that was it. And I see you in the next one.